And good morning, and welcome to Scotty Ray's Weather. I'm Scotty Ray. It's Saturday morning. When I got up earlier this morning, had a couple of coffees, it was around 42. Nippy outside. It's warmed up since then, about 50 this morning as you're getting ready to start your day. As we move into things, let's first go ahead and start talking about what the National Weather Service says for today. Brought to you by MEPA, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. We go over and take a look at what's going on with the burn ban. There's no burn ban, but they're saying there's fire danger. If you burn in any of these counties, be extra cautious because it's dry and things can light on fire quickly. And that includes all of our immediate listening area, what we would call that, from Philadelphia to up to Kosciuszko through Clark County and Laurel and Hattiesburg, all of these areas over to Vicksburg. So be cautious. It's real easy right now to want to go ahead and burn something with these pretty days, but it could get away from us with it being so dry. We'll tell you about when the next chance of rain is going to be coming. It's a little ways off, but we'll bring that up here in just a few moments. Other things that are up and going with weather that we wanted to share today. This storm here, at this point, nothing to really worry about. This is not a tropical storm. Nothing to worry about there either. That's going to just slide away. But we'll watch this. Nothing's going to happen with this in the next 48 hours. Most likely won't, but they're watching it very closely. We'll see what happens over the next 48 hours, should this turn into something or not. As we look at the climate, what's going to be happening with temperatures, it shows that it'll be warming up a little bit here over the next 10 days. We'll look at that extended forecast to just see how that's going to be affecting us also. As we turn to where storm predictions are today, we're going to have a little bit here in Arkansas, a little bit in Tennessee, and South Florida. Looks like it'll have a little bit of taste of some storms today. So that's where we are on the forecast so far this morning. As you woke up this morning, one of the things that you probably noticed was, well, it was chilly. And sometimes you go to turn on that air conditioning, that heat, when it changes from that, it doesn't exactly work right. Or maybe your gas logs wouldn't turn on. They got dirt. They got air from the dirt and stuff in them from the winter. Well, let me tell you about Sanders Gas. They can come out and take care of this for you. They can come out and do a tune-up to your unit there. If it's not working right, it's not properly heating right, for $49.99, they'll come out and take a look at it and let you know what's going on with it and get you back going once again. You can give Chuck and them a call. They'll be glad to come out and help you with that. That's one of the neat things. Now, you've heard me talking about it. Who likes to lose power? I certainly don't. And it's happened over and over when we get storms, and we'll have some more rounds coming in November with the threat of bad weather. And then as we get into the spring months, we all know tornadoes happen and we lose power. Should in the dead of winter there be cold weather and limbs break, ice like that, well, you lose power. Talk to Sanders Gas about a Generac generator. This is one. I want you to look how small this is. For around $6,000, you can have this installed. It will automatically turn on. Look at that. That's small. Very, very affordable. It'll come on and it'll run your entire house. I've got one ordered. I've got three different air conditioning units. It's easy to use. And look how small that is. Talk to them about that. You'd be shocked and you won't have to be without power anymore. It'll save you time. It'll keep you warm. It'll keep you cool. Whatever the case is, you won't be without power anymore. And, you know, we're all used to the big generators, the diesel ones that run off. This runs off propane. It'll tie into your existing or natural gas, whichever you've got, and you don't have to worry about having to have the carburetors worked on every few years. All butane there turns on automatically. You don't have to worry about filling it up with diesel, keeping all that going. It'll run off your tank. When they fill up your gas, it'll take care of itself. So see Chuck. He'll certainly help you out with that. That is a great thing. So keep that in mind with whatever you're doing. And if you want to no longer be without power, that'd be the way to go. A few things in the news this morning before we get back to weather. As we look at some of these headlines that are across America, and it is something to make you go, huh? As you look at this, ABC Silent, after their town hall meeting, and it was turned up that the Obama speechwriter was one of the guys that asked Biden a question. And another person there that was asking questions was the wife of a prominent Democrat. Now, do you think they accidentally got in? ABC's not answering anything on that. It sounds like it was some softball going on. Also, as you get into this, we hadn't heard the last of this. They've identified Joe as the big guy, and he would receive 10% of a Chinese deal. There's a whole lot more of that to come. Do we know the extent of this? Do we know everything that is true? No, not yet. They have, I think, identified that to be his computer without a shadow of a doubt at this point. So stay tuned. It could be some serious stuff come out of this before it's all said and done. Well, as we go to radar this morning, let's get back to weather again. It's always good to have that, isn't it? Let's go back over and take a look at this as we pull up radar this morning. We've got freeze warnings up here in West Virginia. Advisories here with frost down in the Carolinas, there on the edge of the Carolinas. And again, this is a fire watch up in this area. But as we go to Mississippi and start looking at our temperatures, Jackson checking in at 50 this morning, Meridian officially at Key Field at 49. We had the Naval Air Station Meridian this morning at 41. So that is nippy. But one great thing, if you'll notice on this, there's no rain. But that's also where I mentioned the burn ban a minute ago. No burn ban, but not to burn because it is so dry. That is an issue that we're having to deal with right now. As we pull down and pull up the extended forecast for Meridian, let's see what we've got over the next little bit. As we said today, it's going to be somewhere around 70, 81 for tomorrow. We've got 82 on Monday. But look at this. We don't get a chance of rain until Thursday and Friday, really. Friday being our biggest day to get rain. And as we showed those climate of it being warmer, that's it. It's going to hit in the 80s. It will be the following week before we go back, that last week of October going into November before we'll get back down to the 70s again. But nice weather for us, though. It's not going to be bad at all. As if you're getting ready to, for a hunting trip, a bow hunting trip this afternoon, the winds are going to be 5 to 10 miles an hour becoming southeast by the afternoon. So you'll kind of know what you're doing if you're going in the morning, before or after church. Southeast wind around 5 miles an hour. So that's what to kind of plan for if you've got your day set up for that. But here we go on that extended forecast there, that rain moving in back toward the weekend. So that's our first chance. So be careful with matches out there. It can become nasty very quickly and get away from you. And as we speak of deer season, the folks at the Farm Supply, if you hadn't been by, they got you prepared on anything that you could be looking for. Out taking care of anybody that might be doing anything to the yard in the fall, they've got the mums, the pansies, the fruit trees, all of your T-shirts and blue jeans and all of that. You need a coat, they got that. Boots, work boots, they're great. When we get into deer season, and they really try hard to take care of what you need. If you're needing a new pop-up tent, they got those. If you're needing a call, if you're needing deer scents, as we all know in Meridian, Mississippi, deer scents, as you get on in toward January start, well, they're hard to get because everybody makes a mad dash when the rut comes and they kind of end up missing. If you're needing any type of burlap, they got that for you to take care of it when it comes to deer season. As we move in, plenty of feeders. If you're looking for Moultrie, they've got that, whether it's gravity-fed, if you're wanting the new built-in electric varmint guard. Very nice. All your deer attractants that you might be needing, including heaters, and then we get over here into the salt licks. It's just loaded up for deer season. There's no other way to put it. From your cameras to your flashlights, this is your all-in-one place to shop for anything that might be deer hunting. They've got all your seed, and I know there's some folks scrambling this morning to get that taken care of, getting these food plots done because of the rain coming in next weekend. Your southern wheat, you've got forage oats, crimson clover mixed in with that southern buck. And, of course, you can still take advantage of doing what you've always done, your wheat, your oats, and your ryegrass. And, as always, they are a Farm Supply. They do take care of your horse and cattle needs, your hogs, all of that for you, including guns these days. That's right. They've got a full gun department there at the Farm Supply now, from scopes and all the ammunition you may need. Again, that is the Lauderdale County Farm Supply. See them today. They'll bend over backwards to earn your business. Good folks, you've known them. You've seen them for years. Same folks, same great quality at the Lauderdale County Farm Supply. And again, today, it's just going to be great weather. It's if you're going to be outside working, 70 to 71 for that high, that is perfect. And we'll have a little bit of a 5 to 10 southeast wind this afternoon. So how could you ask for anything better for a Saturday? Looks great for tomorrow, too. You won't get wet going to church either. So that's a quick look at your forecast brought to you by EMEPA. And a lot of great folks that help us here each and every day that I want to say thank you to. That's Hoopers, also along with Rick Justice Automotive there on North Frontage Road. Piggly Wiggly, good hometown folks. The Farm Supplies, I mentioned them. Freeman Tractor out in, you can't miss them. And also EMEPA that keeps those lights on for you every day, along with Graphics Guru. If you're needing anything that becomes with a sign or anything like that. They can do it for you. Decals on your trucks. SMI Automotive, if you need a winch or you need a lift kit, anything like that, they do that for you. Truck accessories, including San Marcos. You can find Chino, my friend, there. You can also drop in and see our friends at Eastgate Tire there in Marion. Great folks. Make you a heck of a deal on a set of tires and back up what they do. Drop in and see Matthew. He'll help you. Real good folks there in Marion and Sanders Gas. Kim's Photography. The list goes on of just great folks right here in our community. See them. They'll certainly help you in any way they can. Hear from Scotty Ray's Weather.
Hurricane season is here, and like most Mississippians, you know the drill. Organize a severe weather safety kit, know how to safely use a generator, and have a plan of action to keep your family safe if a hurricane threatens. And when outages do occur, you can now report and view current outages through our free smartphone app or website at emepa.com. Remember, when storms come in, be ready if the power goes out. East Mississippi Electric Power Association is your local Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Scotty Ray's Weather is brought to you by